In this video, I'm going to recommend a budget-conscious wedding video gear kit that you could use to build your portfolio. You might feel like you need to drop thousands of dollars to come up with a great kit, but the reality is, if you're relatively new to filming weddings, you can more than get away with what I'm about to recommend. Overall, I'm budgeting for around $2,500 spent. That's also taking into consideration potential sales taxes. Because most of my audience are American, I'll be speaking in USD, meaning if you're Canadian like me or from another country whose currency is valued differently, you might be looking at a number slightly different than $2,500. I will not be including drones or gimbals in this kit, but I will touch base on those things later in the video. Also, I'm assuming you have a working computer to edit on, and speaking of editing, just go ahead and download the free version of DaVinci Resolve. That's gonna be your daily driver. Okay, let's start things off with my first gear recommendation, the Sony A6400. You can buy this camera new at $900, but because it's been around since 2019, I highly recommend you buy one used. You can most likely find one on Facebook Marketplace for $700, no problem. A big plus of this camera is the included log picture profiles. Now, if you didn't know what a log profile is, think of it as a slightly opaque gray filter over your image. And what it's doing is preserving your exposure and desaturating your colors, so when it comes time for editing, you can add your own color to the image, and you could also choose how you want to expose your image based on the look you're going for. Now, you might be asking if shooting log is necessary, and at the beginner stage, it's absolutely not. But over time, grading log footage does become easier, and you'll really open up your skills as a professional when color grading. I'll link to one of my older videos where I show you a basic beginner way to grade SLog2. The main reason I'm recommending the 6400 over something like the newer Sony ZV-E10 is because, unlike the ZV-E10, the 6400 has a viewfinder that can really help on bright sunny days. It's also weather sealed for rainy days. Now, if you could live without those two things, I would just get the ZV-E10 as it comes in at $798 brand new, and like the A6400, comes with various picture profiles like S-Log. The 6400 does lack internal stabilization, however, the next thing on the list will more than make up for it. The Tamron 17-70 2.8 lens. This lens is incredible and will probably keep me using APS-C cameras for years to come. You can pick one up brand new on sale for $700, which is a little pricey for an APS-C lens, but hear me out. You're actually getting 25.5mm to 105mm, which is a fantastic focal range and why I'm recommending it. Equally important is it's got built-in image stabilization, or as Tamron likes to call it, vibration compensation. Now, the A6400 does not have in-body image stabilization, which makes pairing it with this lens the perfect match. Together, they weigh in at 1.9 pounds, which is like next to nothing, but if you wanted to go even lighter and cheaper, for $540, you could get the Sigma 18-50 2.8, which works out to 27-75mm, which is good, but not as good as the Tamron 17-70mm, plus it's got image stabilization. Next, get yourself a lightweight tripod. I recommend this small rig ball head tripod for $70. Ball head tripods are designed for situations where you're not gonna move from too much, and they're perfect for recording ceremonies and speeches. Speaking of ceremony and speeches, you're going to need something to record audio. I recommend getting two Sony TX660s for $105 each. During the ceremony, you can mic both the officiant and groom for speeches, and you can mic the speaker and attach the other recorder to the mic the speaker will be speaking into. Don't worry about feedback, you won't have any since these lav mics don't emit any wireless frequencies. The clip-on feature is a pretty big deal in my opinion, especially for newer videographers, because it's simple to use and the user, you know, can pretty much mic themselves. My next recommendation is a subscriber favorite, the Uango 216 lights. For $78, I would get two of them along with two lightweight light stands costing $38 for a pair. This gives you a very easy and lightweight way to just take light with you and point it wherever you want. If you haven't yet, you're going to realize that you'll be buying a lot of miscellaneous items. None more miscellaneous than SD cards and batteries. You could pick up a couple of 128 GB memory cards for around $50, 3 aftermarket A6400 batteries for $36, and a pair of MPF 970 batteries that power the Young Nuo lights for $67, bringing your grand total before applicable taxes to $2,015. Like I said earlier, I wasn't going to include drone or gimbals, and that's primarily because of cost. Based on the kit I've recommended, I actually think you can pull off a bunch of really good handheld or monopod shots. And for a while earlier in my wedding filming career, I was doing just that, using no gimbals and using some drone shots here and there. It taught me how to compose and use light properly. So now when I pick up my gimbal, I keep those things in mind. Now, with all that being said, I know some of you are gonna completely ignore me and go get a drone and gimbal. So here's what I recommend, starting with the DJI RSC2. I would definitely not buy this brand new, and I'd look for a used unit in the $200 to $300 range. I owned this gimbal for quite a while, and like everything DJI makes, it was a workhorse for me when I needed it. Alternatively, you could also get the Zhiyun Weibo 3 brand new for $300. I don't know much about it other than its favorable reviews. Regardless, either one of these will get the job done. For drones, I would get the Mini 3 Pro because it's got a picture profile known as D-Cinelike, which is not log, but log-ish. You also don't need a license to fly or have to register it with the FAA. I made a video detailing 5 things I really like about it, so check it out if you're interested. Okay, there's one more thing, just one more thing I recommend you get and start using immediately, which is a music licensing subscription. We are all guilty of using popular mainstream music in our videos when we're first starting. Not only is that illegal, but your videos will also never be authentically you. Everyone is quick to say get MusicBed because they have the best music. However, since switching from MusicBed to Artlist, I find it to be more than what I need and it's much more affordable. At the time of this video, a MusicBed wedding or commercial license will cost you $80 a month. And if you get a yearly subscription, you'll receive a slight discount, but you're looking at a whopping $879 for the year. Now compare that with my Artlist Music Pro subscription at $199 for the year. Unless you can magically book 10 $1,000 weddings off the bat, getting a MusicBed subscription just doesn't make financial sense in my opinion. This video is not sponsored by Artlist, I just genuinely really like them, and I also think they have more music suited to different cultures, which is a big plus for me. Again, I'm not sponsored, but I will leave my referral link in the description down below, and if you sign up, you'll get 2 extra months free on top of a yearly subscription. So you'll get 14 months in total for the price of 12. Just make sure you get the pro subscription and not the social one, because the social one does not cover commercial projects, which is what a wedding is. So if this helped, make sure you like and subscribe for future videos. If you own any of these items, let us know your thoughts. And as always, if you have any questions, please ask them. See you in the next video.